the day that never came before and will never come again. It is November 17th and this is the 321st drop of the living water. We are in a very specific topic. We are told, Apostle Paul told us that there are a couple of things. He listed things that we need to be saved in our salvation. We need to fix these things. If we are not there yet, we have to fix. So that is what we are studying. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 2 to 3. The last thing in that list we are learning that unity in the spirit. Unity in the spirit. So that is, let me summarize what we learned up to now today. Unity in the spirit is completely different than the other unities. This unity is specifically spiritual. Not physical, not emotional, not social, but spiritual. And also it is another very important thing. This is eternal. Not temporary, not in the world, but it is eternal. So these are the two important facts about the unity in the Holy Spirit. Now, as we, having said that, it is spiritual, means the Holy Spirit in me and the Holy Spirit, same Holy Spirit in you, that means the same spirit to spirit connected, and as a result, consequently, you and I are connected. That is how we connect, unity. There are some questions and problems and issues in practical life. Why? I think that I am in the spirit, the Holy Spirit is in me, and you think the same way, but you and I are not connected. We cannot be together. I don't know, there's something wrong. Cannot be united. We found the reason why. Because one person has the Holy Spirit, but the other person has only the label of the Holy Spirit, but the inside, the inner person is not the Holy Spirit, but the evil spirit. So I told you, I urged you not to haste to point out the finger to the other person. Let's go through myself. So we did that practical. We came out of ourselves and we looked at, we observed that person from outside. And we went through the checklist, everything that Apostle Paul says in here, Ephesians chapter 4 verse 2 to 3. All humility, gentleness, patience, unity, bond of peace, tolerate with love, all these things. We went through that checklist. If this person has these things, or the opposite, stubbornness, aggressive, impatient, pride, all these things, hatred, if these opposite things are there, then if we found anything opposite to this list, we know that not the Holy Spirit is in me. If I don't have love in me, I have the label, but the Holy Spirit is not there. We know that God is love. If I cannot love you with no condition, that means Holy Spirit. Spirit is not in me. So then we found out all these things and we went through the checklist and we corrected ourselves. That was the practical we have been doing for three days now. So I believe that we observed ourselves and we recognize who is in me, who is the real inner person in me, and we corrected. If we corrected, means unclean spirits are kicked out. And the Holy Spirit is in us now. We welcomed Him. How to know? By fruit. Right? So now, let's move on. Then after that, here it says, be united in the Spirit. Now, this is very important. There are two subtopics, two ways of this united being. First and foremost, if I have hatred, if I have pride, that means Holy Spirit is not in me. Means I am not united with the Spirit in the first place. First, I have to be united with the Holy Spirit. I have to welcome Him again from the beginning, kicking out the unclean spirit and unclean thoughts and the fruits of the enemy. hatred, bitterness, anger, pride, all these things. Kicked out and welcome the Holy Spirit. We have to go back to the first step, inviting Him into my life. Right, so then only I become the mansion, the temple of the living God. Then I have to correct that relationship first to be united with the Holy Spirit. Then it is easy for me to be united with you because you have the Holy Spirit in you. Now I have. Before I did not have. Before I only had the label, the name tag of the Holy Spirit. But inside me, I had hatred, I had bitterness, I had pride, all these things. Now I changed myself, I corrected myself, I am transformed now, and I am connected, I am united with the Holy Spirit. So now, from the beginning, I can be united with you. That is how the church should be united. Some people think that no, I cannot, I am by myself, but I have relationship with the Lord God. Let me grow by myself. Let me ask you a question. The Bible clearly says that the church is a one body of Christ. What if we cut my hand from here, this hand from here, legs are from here, then I put all these four two legs in the two different corners and two arms in the two different corners in the room and I am in the middle. Can the body grow? Within how quick get rotten and done? So no one can grow by themselves. That is why we are put in together, united as a family, as a one body. So that is the will of God. If we are united, if we obey and correct ourselves and united with the other people, then only we can say, your will be done. If not, we cannot even say that prayer. May the Lord God bless you to be united with the parts of the body. They are the parts of you and me.